Today we're going to use Tinkercad and the Sketch Tool to make a fantastic Clicky Fidget. So let's get cracking. We do need a special part. We're going to get that using a template. You can find it by typing bit.ly/HLFidget and the number 1. This is a fantastic Clicky Fidget project. It includes these parts we need right here. It is set to copy in Tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. When you use copy in Tinker, you get an exact copy of my project. As you can see, we've got notes here that explain everything about it. This uses an older strategy. If you want to check it out, of course, there will be a link in here. These pieces right here are locked, so I'm going to unlock them, delete them, and then I'm going to hide the notes. With that out of the way, the first thing I want to do is change the name. I'm going to call this Fidget Star V2, and then these are the parts that matter. These are the holes. Now, I want these to be available forever, so what I'm going to do is click over here and go to Your Creations, and I'm going to create a shape that stores them. Once it loads, I type the name fidget hole. I'm going to lock the part size. It needs to be a hole, and I'm going to save the shape. Then, of course, we click on the fidget key top, and we do the same steps. As you can see, I just did this lately, so I'm not going to do it again. But I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to show you how to delete the extra one, just like that. So whenever I launch Tinkercad, I can always switch to Your Creations and find these two parts for making new fidgets. Do note they do work with Kali keys. There will be a link in the description so you can track down the correct parts. So here's how we're going to build our fidget star. Move back to basic shapes. Find the star and bring it out. We're just going to set it down for a moment and then rotate it negative 18 degrees. This gets it so that it's flat. You can see those line up. And then we're also going to turn on T for transparent. And we're going to find this dotted line that is the center of the shape. I simply want you to line that up with any line on the grid. We're going to stay with this exact same size fidget, and we're going to bring out the sketch tool. Now we're going to set the sketch tool in line with it. We're not going to stack it on. We're just going to set it so it's in line. Notice I've got the dotted line matching again. Now I can move up here and trace this star. Now we can't get exactly to the lines, but we're going to get as close as we can by shutting this off. You can zoom in and try and be unbelievably perfect. It really doesn't matter though. We just want to make the star nice and quick. Notice I'm zooming out, getting the next piece, getting close to that corner, and following it all the way around the shape. If you're off by a tiny bit, I don't think you'll ever know when you finish. And whatever you do make, it'll match for the walls because this is the exact piece that we're working with. Click, click, and bring it home. Once you complete it, you can double click and zoom in and check the corners. If there are any you don't like, you can drag them where you do want them to be. If those dimensions are ever in the way, you can simply click here and hide them in an instant. I am going to be happy with that, and I'm going to hit Finish Sketch. Now I'm going to delete the star, and let's start the project. First thing I'm going to do is bring my grid back to size 1. Let's do T for transparent, and make sure I've got that lined up on a grid again. Now I'm going to hit T to shut off transparency. I'm going to set the height of this piece, the center of my fidget, to 12. I'm going to bring the cap over. And we're going to line it up. L for align, and we want to pick center, center, and we need it to come to the top. As you can see, it is not quite in the center, so I'm going to just bring this down a little bit, and I'm going to make the star part a tiny bit larger. If we check the measurements, see how it's 38.03 by 36. I'm going to use Alt-Shift. We're going to stretch this out. And instead of 38, I'm going to just type 40 and press enter. The one thing we do need to do is set this back to exactly 12 and press enter. This gives us a little bit of room around the fidget clicker hole. And then we're going to do Control D, double click to edit that. And then inside we are going to switch to the stroke tool. We're going to set that stroke on the outside. I'm going to set the stroke width to 1.6 and press enter. I also want to switch the corners and make them round. This makes it more fun to hold, and when we hit finish sketch, we have just built the walls. These need to be 17 high. And then we're going to click on this part, and we're going to use it for the top. Control D, shift nudge to move it over, and it is going to be 4.5 millimeters high. This part right now is standing on its top, so we're going to use the mirror tool to flip it. Now it's got the large base on the bottom, and then we need to line these up. To make sure that we can grab this real easy, let's hide these two. Now we can do shift select L for align, make this one the boss, and it needs to line up just like that. Now we can grab these two, L for align, make the star the boss, and this one needs to be right here. We do show all. We have got both of our holes in place. The final step is to trim this so it fits the right way. This is my favorite part of this technique. W for work plane. Set it on this place. Click right here and do Control D and drop. Change this new one to the hole, and we're going to edit the sketch. We need to click on this one, and we're going to trim away a little bit of this so it fits. To do that, we simply switch to the center line. Right here, you can see how it's going to trim so that fits. Now, we want this to be the sharp edge because that's what our star has. And I'm going to trim away 1 millimeter. That means half is going to be trimmed all the way around. When we hit finish sketch, you can see how that's going to trim that exactly. I'm going to shrink it down so it's closer to the right height. Let's do W for work plane, grab the entire part, and do Control G to union group. Bang! That is where this star is going to fit. Of course, now I can grab these two and also do Control G to group. That, my friends, is your fidget star. Let's say you want to add a name to this real quick. I'm going to simply bring the text out on top. I'm going to type whatever I want inside. I'm going to just put an HL. And then I'm going to use shift squeeze to make it small enough to fit on the star. When I'm happy, I'm going to set the height to 0.5. Make it a hole. Choose my L for align. And I want it to be centered. And I'm going to check this center. I don't like that. So I'm going to back it down to right there. And then I'm going to sync it in once again by doing L for align. Make this one the boss. And I want it to align with the top. One final Control G, and bang, it's ready for 3D printing. I'm going to grab both, choose export, STL. I'm going to store it in my 3D modeling folder as Fidget Star V2, and hit save. Let's quickly bounce to Bambu Studio, create a new project. Let's add the file. There it is, right at the top of the list. Alright, so today I'm going to stay with the 0.2 standard. I am going to switch this to the color red. And if we click slice plate with the 0.2 standard, it is under 24 minutes. Let's hit print plate and send it to the printer to see what we made. And not too much later, we've got fidget parts. Of course, these work with the Cali keys. You can find the link in the description. You do need to find this edge right here, and then it simply snaps in just like that. If you push hard, you get the satisfying click, and then you can grab your star, push it on, and bang, instant clicky fidget. How cool is that? So a quick review of what we learned. Once again, you can trace things using the sketch tool. It's super slick, and the more you use it, the better you'll get. I do also want to highlight trimming with the center line. That is a fantastic way to make a perfect fit, whether you're making a light box, a lid, or any sort of project that has a cool outline. Finally, friends, I want to say thanks to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, support. You get early access to videos. Please also make sure you keep an eye out for those members only posts. I also want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via my Patreon. It is a fantastic group that has passed 300 members. Of course, it has an awesome messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, and post designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you like, hype, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.